of our injection machine. And today we are going to explain how does it work of this machine, what are the processes or steps for to make a good work. Its component will come again, and I hope you enjoy it.
Today I'm going to talk about the crystalline materials. Do you know what are crystalline materials?
No.
No? Okay, let me tell you. Crystalline materials are composed by order chains. If you know, we have two types of materials. Crystalline materials and amorphous materials. I'm going to talk to you with crystalline materials. In the process injection, crystalline and amorphous depends the same mechanism to the melt. There is a big difference because a crystalline material needs more energy than an amorphous material. In an injection molding machine, if you see to there, we have the hopper. Into the hopper, we introduce the plastic in pellets. Introduce the plastic. This passes by the feeding tube to this part into the screw. In this part, the plastic, the pellets plastic, is compacted against the cylinder, but against the header band. But the temperature of the header bands is not enough to the pellets. So the central diameter of the screw, becomes thicker to can melt the pellets. In this part, the pellets pass for this part, and we have a big problem because finally the piece going to have errors on this part because we are using crystalline material. So as a conclusion, I recommend to use a screw. I recommend to use a screw that provides uniformity of fusion so that in the process of the melting, the screw tends to be wetted. So I have another important fact is that we can find the crystalline materials in the nylon, especially the number 6. And I think that's it for the moment.
The amorphous polymers are a long chain. This chain is irregular for the molecules. For the chemical composition, and the solids, the amorphous solids are a lot irregular for the composition. There are some characteristics like it has a characteristic temperature. This temperature is known for vitreous admission. This temperature can be reduced in the injection molding, when the injection plastics, these materials is easy to melt. There need less energy. That's it.
several, the injection machine is exists various types. For example, is a Kruger type and inline Kruger type in the other. In the injection unit, it's necessary form the molder machine inject for the injection of the plastic. It's important find the molding that satisfy this injection or the plastic or the fuel and 70 or 80% of the plastic for one shot on in the area in the cavities or in the mold. Furthermore, is explained for in the nozzle or other parts below is explained in the carbine in unit.
De tu saco. De tu saco.
First in the screen.
when initial pressure in the piston when on the force applied pressure is the moment. The pressure on the applicator in the board face in the front in the piston or the is cold, the pressure do that the melted material flow more faster, and the parts of the mold be unitary, have a unitary density. Another pressure is the back pressure. This back pressure works with the retrograde with the screw when the material is accumulating this part. The screw starts to retrograde, and for another cycle. If we don't have material, the screw doesn't retrograde, and the screw stay in that part. Another important part that we do that the screw retrograde is to expose gases that we have into the injection process. When we retrograde the screw, these gases are expulsed by the copper. Imagine that we have a copper, and this is the copper, and then the gases are expulsed by the copper. And as a conclusion, the pressure are so important. If we don't have pressure, we will have bad pieces in the injection process. That's all.
You mentioned it before, is it some variables in the some try to reduce the cost. In the processes of injection plastic, we have some times. The first one is the closed mold. In the closed mold, the clamping unit closed the mold. And the next one is the advance of the unit injection. In this part, the unit injection moves forward until create a contact with the nozzle. This part is the nozzle. In this part, we can see that the mold is closer. The next one is the injection machine. The injection time. In the injection time, the screw starts to inject the melted inside of the mold. The next one is the compression time. In the compression time, inside of the mold will be applied a kind of pressure. I forgot mention that in the injection time, it will be affected for some parameters, like the kind of plastic that will be used, the temperature that will be used also, and the size of the mold. So that time will have some variables. The next one is the regression time. In this time, the unit injection moved backward, and the screw start to move in a rotatory way. To that permit that the plastic that are inside of the mold start to cooling. The next one is the cooling time. In this time, the mold, the plastic start to cooling inside of the cavities of the mold. And the final time is the ejection and open mold and the ejection. In this part, the mold are open, and the final piece that is cooling now are ejected using the ejector piece. In this part, we can see an image of a mold. Like my classmate mentioned it before, we have the cavity, is this part. The bushings that help to the mold keep closing during all the injection. And in this part, we can see the ejector pins that help us to eject the final piece. Why it's so important to try to reduce the cost? The time. If we reduce time, we can reduce cost, and we will have a more production of pieces, and that will be very helpful. That will be very good for our production. But if we try to reduce the time, it's very important not reduce the quality of our product, because if we reduce the quality of our final pieces, reduce the time and reduce the cost don't have any sense. So that will be us. Thank you.
Hi everyone. I am going to explain what is a shrinkage. Shrinkage is a phenomenon in which the volume of the plastic melted within the cavity mold is contracted at the time to cool it. Most of the part shrinkage occurs in the mold while cooling. But there is a small contraction. Small contraction after injection. The shrinkage of the PSF can be caused by the following aspect: low injection, high temperature mold, or high melting temperature. Also, cooling time. In a conclusion, any polymers, they have a relation between the pressure, volume, and temperature. They are very important to obtain an efficient injection process.
That's all.